Hi, I'm Heather. I'm one of the systems engineers here at Pessler. Today in this tutorial, we're going to talk about channel limits. Within our sensors, you could set upper or lower threshold limits on various sensors, depending when you want to define something as warning or critical, and that helps you to decide when you're going to be notified. So let's go take a look together at this. All right, to set the channel limits, we have to go into a sensor in our interface. For this example, I'm going to start with a disk-free sensor. You change the channel limits with the gearbox under the gouge or on the right side of the channel. So here I'm clicking on the gouge and you'll see that we have upper and lower limits. An upper limit might be used for something where you want to be alerted on a high value such as CPU load or SNMP traffic. But in disk space, especially for disk-free, you want to be alerted when it gets low, when less space is available. So by default, these ones are set at 25 for a lower warning limit and 10% for a lower error limit. But say that doesn't meet my needs. So for this example, I'm going to set it to 50 for the lower warning, 25 for the lower error. When I say OK, you're going to see here how the limits do change now in the gouge. And I'm technically in a warning sensor state right now because of my limits that I set. All right, so now let's take a look at free bytes. Because free bytes does not have any limits set right now. So when I click on the gearbox in there, I can go under limits and say enable alerting based on limits. And here we can have a lower error limit of 5 gigabytes and a lower warning limit of 10 gigabytes. I can also put a message in here and I could say, disk is running low, for example. And then for the error, I could say, disk is critical. So when those limits come up, I'll get a message in PRTG for that as well. Now, this is an example for a disk. Let's take a look at something else with a high limit. I'm going to take a look at CPU. So when I come into my CPU load sensor here, I don't have any limits set. I click on that same gearbox, and I can enable the alerting here. This one will have upper limits, 80 and 60. We're going to say OK, and now you can see it's set. If you do want to put your sensor channel limits into templates, you can do that, and that also allows you to set it across multiple sensors at one time. There are also a few ways that we can do multi-edits. You can type in a sensor and do a search. So here, for example, we're going to take a look at SNMP traffic. And I'm going to just pick a couple sensors and put my gearbox in the multi-edit settings. And if you go to the channel settings and pick the channel, and for here we'll do traffic total. You can check the limits, enable alerting based on limits, and then set the limits that you'd like to set. In addition to that, you can always go to the sensor list and take a look at sensors by type or tag and set limits accordingly that way by selecting. So here I'm going to take a look at an SMTP sensor. I can multi-select all those sensors, click on the gearbox, and again you set the channel limits here. Pick the limits you want, the channel you want, and then you can change, set your alerting there. And one last way that you can do multi-edit is through the management tab in the interface. With that, you can use a control key to select multiple sensors and then do multi-edits through there. If you'd like to get alerting based upon these values on these limits, you can use triggers to set up notifications on these sensors.
If you find this video helpful, feel free to like it and consider watching our other videos on our channel. If you still have questions, please contact support@pessler.com, and always feel free to comment for feedback or suggestions for other topics. Thank you.